Good afternoon, students. Today, I'm going to begin with the second chapter of your moral science book. Please go to page number 13. The chapter is Believe in God. The first chapter we discussed, it's also about God. Okay. This chapter is just continuation of that chapter, you can say, regarding thought. So, if you believe in God, God is going to help you and He is going to protect you from all the troubles. Okay, so here one story is given. One night I had a dream. I dreamed I was walking along the beach with the Lord. So here the author was saying about one dream where he was walking with Lord, with God, with he was walking on the beach, and four or five scenes, or maybe he saw that he has seen two sets of footprints. Okay, then at last, on the last scene, when he looked back, he saw that there is only one set of footprint, and when he looked back, he found that those times where he saw only one set of footprints, that was the toughest time of his life. Then he asks God, God, you told me that you will be with me, but at my toughest time, you left me. Then God answered, no, I have not left you. Actually, that was the time when I was carrying you. I'll never leave you alone. So what you have learned? So if you believe in God, He's not going to leave you. He's going to help you. One more story is given in your book, that is your Prahlad, the true devotee. Prahlad was the son of the king Hiranyakashyap, who never believed in God. But Prahlad, he believed in God, and that his father, he was not liking it. He tried many things, but he did not succeed. Okay, so what he did, at last he wanted to kill Prahlad. First, he threw Prahlad from the top of the mountain, but Prahlad rolled down safely and remained unhurt. Then he threw Prahlad in front of mad elephant, but elephant lifted Prahlad gently and made him sit on the their back. Okay, then this Hiranyakashyap again, he threw Prahlad into ocean, but waves brought Prahlad safely to the shore. Hiranyakashyap even gave poison to Prahlad, but it did not affect Prahlad at all. So just see how, what are the things he did. Hiranyakashyap did not believe in God, but his son believed, and because of that, he tried to kill his son. At last, when all the attempts to kill Prahlad failed, he took the help of his sister Holika. Holika was blessed with one shawl which does not catch fire. Okay, so she told that she is going to wear that shawl and she'll sit with Prahlad on the fire. And according to that, they planned. She took Prahlad on her lap and she wore the shawl. And then at that time, God again helped. A strong wind blew, which did not extinguish the fire, but made the shawl fly from Holika's body over Prahlad's body. So at that time, what God did, he sent a strong wind, okay, which does not extinguish the fire. The fire was the fire was there, but the shawl which Holika was wearing, that shawl went to Prahlad's body. So Prahlad was safe and Holika died. Okay, so like that, God helped him. So, but if you see, lots of things were done with Prahlad, and he made all the attempts to kill Prahlad. So at last, God was very angry, and he decided to kill this Hiranyakashyap. So he took the avatar of Narasimha. I think you heard that about Vishnu's avatar of Narasimha. So he took that avatar and he killed Hiranyakashyap. And with the blessings of God, Prahlad became the new king of the place. So from this story, what you have learned? That God always does what is good for you. And He always tests your faith and patience. So always believe in God, He'll always help you. So in your next class, we'll do the question answers. Okay, if you have any kind of doubt regarding this chapter, please ask me during the class or clarification hour. Thank you.